questions.
Frank, what did you make of that just total effort from LeBron, 39 minutes? I know he played last game, was that fourth quarter, but just kind of carrying through the team on what seemed to be an off night?
Yeah, I mean, he was huge in the fourth quarter. You know, obviously carried us through a tough stretch, helped us build the lead up in that fourth. And, you know, credit the Kings for playing a terrific basketball game all four quarters, but in particular for not folding at during that stretch. And he fought back and clawed back into the game. But, you know, LeBron was great building that lead and then obviously closing out with the two big free throws at the end.
Frank, what AD had to do and recognize on that play to be able to make the block on the Kings' last possession?
Well, it was really just our basic coverage. He's the low man. You know, we got split on the handoff switch, and Barnes came to the basket, and you know, that's AD's as good as anybody in the world, you know, at making that play, and he made a terrific play to save the game.
In general, you know, what do you think it says about AD that, you know, not the best offensive night he's had, but still playing a lot of late defense, especially against Barnes on some of those switches?
Well, that's what's special about him. You know, I mean, he can just impact the game even when he's not going offensively, or they're double teaming him. It wasn't really that he was having an off night. They were double teaming every time he touched it. And, you know, for him to impact the game the way he did on the other end of the floor just shows what kind of special player he is.
Frank, you started KCP, but then went to Caruso early and then again at the start of the second half. Wondering if you could explain what was kind of behind that. And then it seemed like you got great contributions from both of them at different points of the game. Just curious, without your first game without Avery, what you thought of those guys?
They were going to try to junk the game up a little bit, you know, putting a lot of cross matches out there. You know, they're doing the Pat Bev plan of just having Corey pick up LeBron full court and deny him full court. And then you could either, you know, wear him out the whole game doing that, or you just put another ball handler in. So that's why we went to Alex. But, you know, KCP exemplified our next man up mindset today with Avery going down. And, you know, he stepped in and played terrific defense all night. And then obviously down the stretch, he had great energy, you know, with his speed cuts, feeding the ball on the post, and then made some big shots when we really needed them. So credit KCP for really stepping up tonight.
Frank, you had mentioned you know, crediting Sacramento for not kind of folding when you guys would make those pushes. It happened three or four times. You guys were up by eight or whatever it was. Was that more of a them thing pushing, or are you guys getting a little complacent with the lead?
No, I credit them. I mean, look, they're playing extremely well, you know, and they space you out. You know, they're shooting a three ball extremely well, especially Buddy and Bogdanovich. And look, they made 16 threes and they shot 39. I feel like we defended a lot of them really well, but you know, they're knocking them down anyway. And when you have that kind of threat at the 3-point line, it really extends your defense, makes it difficult to protect the paint. So credit them for playing a terrific game.
It kind of seemed like at the end, LeBron and AD were almost switching on to Bogdanovich because he really had it going at the end there. Was that by design, or was that them?
Well, it's just to try to stay out of rotations and just guard those guys out of switching. You know, I mean, that's kind of what our base defense was. Their guy came into it. So, you know, rather than get into rotations, we just switched out and tried to guard one-on-one.
You mentioned earlier, Frank, KCP had a really big fourth quarter. His season's been up and down a lot. What is it that you like about him that gives you the confidence for the fourth quarter moments like that?
Well, I would say his season has not really been up and down. I think his scoring has been up and down. But he's one of the guys on our team that brings the highest level of energy. One of his talents is how hard he plays. You know, and when you have a guy that plays as hard as he does, it impacts the energy on the floor. It's part of our identity of making the whole group be a play harder type of team. And he's an excellent defender, and we're number one defense in the league, and he's a big part of that. So, you know, I don't feel like he's really had an up and down type of season. I think he's been really consistent with his energy and with his defense, and the shots come and gone a little bit, but it was there for us tonight.
So is that is that an element that you consider just reliable in itself? You know that's going to be there when he's there?
Yes. I mean, you gotta have an arm. Look, the firepower in this league with the style of play that this league plays with nowadays, you need as many perimeter defenders that you can trust and can get out and guard and have speed and containment ability as you can. And, you know, he's one of those soldiers for us. And, you know, I know he gets a lot of criticism for his offense, but, you know, he's capable of knocking down big shots like we saw tonight, and he brings consistent energy on the defensive end.
Hey, Frank, closing games, you've had some success going big with Dwight in there. Kuzma has been coming on. How do you approach that? It's not as simple as offense, defense, but what's your mindset when trying to figure out those that situation?
Just a feel for the game. You know, we have a rotation that sets us up for the final 3 or 4 minutes to just make a read on, you know, what the matchups look like, which guys really had a better night, you know, what the game calls for. You know, if we feel like we need weak side shooting because we're going to be double teamed, we probably go with Kuz. You know, if they're getting to the basket on us and we need, you know, some rim protection, we'll probably go with Dwight. It's really what the game calls for.
Thanks, Frank. Thanks, everyone.